All right, Ken. Fred Sasakamoose, one of the first Indigenous athletes to play in the NHL, has died after being hospitalized with COVID-19 at the age of 86 years old. Ken, for those who aren't aware of who he was, what was the impact that Fred had on the game of hockey and, frankly, the world?
Well, I mean, on the game of hockey, he was the first Treaty Indigenous person to play in the NHL. He played 11 games for the Chicago Blackhawks in 1953-54. And like his NHL career, that was it. I mean, he scored no goals, no assists, no points, and had 6 penalty minutes. So his NHL career wasn't super noteworthy. But I think, you know, I think the fact that he was a guy that, you know, that did it first before anyone else. And secondly, you know, I mean, this was a guy who went through the residential school system in Canada. And I'm not sure if people are familiar with, you know, that whole saga in Canadian history, but it is really a dark spot on Canadian history. It's almost like Canada's slavery. It was cultural genocide. You know, kids were, you know, Native kids were taken from their families and put in residential schools where, you know, they were under the, you know, under the guise of sort of assimilating them into society. They, you know, a lot of them were abused. A lot of them were treated very, very badly. Fred Sasakamoose was one of them. Sadly, he was raped by another student there, had coal oil poured on his head once when he tried to escape the school. You know, so to come to, you know, I mean, to play in the NHL is one thing at a time when, you know, there's only 120 jobs. It's a 16 league. You know, that's amazing. But to do it under that backdrop and to overcome those kinds of obstacles, I think is another thing. And then after his career, you know, he went back to Saskatchewan and lived on the same reserve that he grew up on and, you know, became a real elder, a leader, a mentor, you know, started a lot of programs. He has an arena named after him there. You know, he helped a lot of people there and, you know, really led a pretty exemplary life.
And you've obviously got to learn a lot about him. You got to talk to some family members. What's an interesting story that you like to share about him?
Well, I think the one that to me, I mean, I talked to him a couple of years ago for a piece that I did. He was like 80, he was in his early 80s, I think then. He was still working out 2 hours a day. Wow. You know, he was doing all sorts of stuff, really, really active and everything. And by all accounts, was very active right up until, you know, he contracted COVID, you know, in like the last week. His son was telling me that he had a picture of him, you know, plowing snow on his quad and stuff. So, you know, a really active, really vibrant guy who I think for me, the big takeaway was that he didn't live, you know, his life as a bitter guy, you know, over what happened to him. You know, about 4 or 5 years ago, or maybe more than that, Canada had what was called a Truth and Reconciliation Commission, where they got the stories of a lot of the kids who went through residential schools. And for the first time, for, you know, at like the age of 79 or 78, Fred Sasakamoose told his story about what happened to him there. You know, that takes a lot of bravery. That takes a lot of courage. You know, he cried, but he also told me, he said, you know, it gave him the capacity to forgive. And, you know, I think that's the big takeaway with a guy like this. I mean, you know, his NHL career was very short and not terribly consequential, but I think, you know, through hockey and a lot of other ways, he touched a lot of people.
Thank you, Ken. Fred Sasakamoose was 86.